Hello, fellow YouTubers, this is 3200 Music Circle, and you know, I'm doing a pointless continuation. On the cheek. Anyway, Dragon Ball Evolution. God, it was goofy! Jeez! They never should have done a live action movie. What was it? Yeah, Dragon Ball Evolution. I'm even forgetting the title, which, thank God. Light. Perfect. Anyway, the whole thing was so kind of weird, and in the first 5 minutes, you know, Goku seems so freaking, you know, modern. And he acts like a human. I barely even knew who the heck was Goku in this, you know. But that's because he had no crazy hair. And when he was riding to school, the faces he's making, the faces he always makes in the whole movie. That's one of my big complaints. Along with that, the live action characters look so goofy compared to Dragon Ball Z. And that's really saying something, because for one, on Dragon Ball Z, the characters were so zany and all that shit. I mean, so weird looking, but they look good in animation. Now they look fucking stupid. But at the end of the movie, you saw Goku actually have his hair, kind of like in the original movie. I like the taste of the shells. I don't eat the shells because that would make my shit hurt. And even worse, Bulma in the movie, I mean in the original Dragon Ball Z series, looked nothing like she did in the movie, or the movie looked nothing like Bulma in this series, because the only thing we noticed from Bulma was she had that little blue hair curl. That's all we noticed, and she also worked for Capsule and had all that tech shit. Jeez. You know, the whole time I kept thinking, this is okay. And even sometimes, Goku did the grunts he did in Dragon Ball Z. But what can I say? It's fucking Dragon Ball Z based. But it's called Dragon Ball Evolution or Revolution, I don't know. This is not a good movie. It does no justice. I think it's actually trying to bring back, I mean, it was trying to bring back Dragon Ball Z Kai. Hell, it was made in 2009. Some ideas were pitched in 2009 to bring back Dragon Ball Z. And then in all the way into May, that's when, you know, it was, you know, premiered on Nicktoons. Soon, I mean, about 5 or 10 years after it was taken off Cartoon Network. That's good. But why isn't it on Nickelodeon, not Nicktoons? Because it's got to be more mainstream. Hell, why can't all the other good shows that everyone wants brought back should not be on primetime? For example, Emperor's New School. We like that. It was kind of funny. And I wonder if David Spade actually did the voice in The Emperor's New School. Although he was in some weird movies. And it looks even cooler though. Though his voice is high.
Hello. I'm David Spade. Yeah.
Though it looks so cool. And yet his voice is so stupid. Anyway. With Dragon Ball Z being brought back onto Nicktoons, it's not doing good for me. I mean, it's not doing good for the series, because if it's not on Nickelodeon, people aren't gonna notice. There's not even that many people going to Nicktoons. Hell, even Nicktoons are straying away from why they are and what they are. Because they rerun all the classic shows. Now they're bringing back shit. Iron Man, Armored Avengers, fuck. Put that on Nickelodeon. And keep it off of our shows. We like Rocko's Modern Life. We like Capta. We like Invader Zim. Invader Zim should be back on Nickelodeon too. Something we can watch. You know what? Fuck it. Have people judge all these shows. See if they suck or not. And if they do, replace them. And then have them all the classic shows. We love that. On Nickelodeon with all those classic shows we used to watch as a kid. But now these kids in our generation are becoming so stupid now. I mean, seriously. This is what's happening because they're drastically changing SpongeBob. And Fanboy and Chum Chum is actually more modernly, I mean, it's more modern than Ren and Stimpy. And that's probably why they're drastically changing it. I mean, what I mean is Transformers. Because Tom Kenny had to play the voice, not SpongeBob, not for SpongeBob, but for Transformers. As Patches and Skids, racism names. Sunflower seeds. You can be grossed out if you want to be. I got a trash bag too. You know, right here. So no need to worry and think my room is a disgusting mess. I guess Homer Simpson was right when he was on the David Letterman show, oh boy, saying TV is not a wasteland, it's a cesspool. But it's more like a wasteland, surrounding a cesspool. Mm-hmm. Actually, a wasteland on top of a cesspool, the wasteland's becoming a cesspool. However you would explain it, it's just that bad. So, yeah, I mean, seriously, they are so far out there. These movies suck. These TV shows suck. You know what? How about we have a whole TV marathon? We vote online. We gradually go, and everyone pitches the TV shows for nominations for being taken off. And then everyone votes what TV shows should be taken off and then replaced. And that way we can drop a lot of the actors in stupid shows and stop paying these people for making stupid shows we don't like. Example, reality shows. They're not creative. They're not fun to watch. They suck. Reality shows suck, and that's why we gotta have creative writers. If you have a writer's strike or someone suggests a writer's strike, please shoot them. Shoot them straight in the head. We like our good shows. We love watching these shows. But every time there's a writer's strike, there's even a bigger chance we get a reality show. Focus on that. Focus in on that. Whatever. Check out my next vlog. Hear more of my shit. Learn more of my, you know, speaking. Still watching on this video, I say go to the next one. And you're still watching, go to the next video. Good.